A Guide to Golf. Golf has seen an incredible rise in popularity over the past few decades, and that popularity continues to grow. From the days when golf was considered the pastime of a select few old folks who walked the greens in their checked pants, the sport today has a tremendous following. It can largely be attributed to players like Tiger Woods, charismatic players who captured the attention of everyone, including those who have never picked up a golf club. Added to this is Hollywood's take with movies that have portrayed golfers as the heroes they are. While the following has changed significantly, so has the industry. There are resorts, vacation packages, and even housing developments built around incredible golf courses. Finding a great place to golf has never been easier, with the number of courses growing annually and those managing the courses set to make the most of the property available. There's no way to really tell what prompted the rising popularity of the sport, but if you look at the number of young people walking the greens with parents and grandparents, and the number of schools with a golf program for its students, you'll see that it's most likely a trend that will continue for the foreseeable future. The History of Golf. Arguably, golf's interesting origin began 5 centuries in the past. It is a historical fact that due to the interference of golf with much more serious combat drills, James II of Scotland banned golf in an Act of Parliament on March 6th in the year 1475. There is a general agreement among historians and golf fans alike that the Scots were the first golfers who became somewhat addicted to the sport. However, the persons responsible for the invention of golf is open to debate, and debate will ensue if you breach the subject with the right persons. It has been suggested that bored sheepherders became quite exceptional at knocking round-shaped stones into rabbit holes with their wooden shepherd staffs. Making a competitive game of the boredom seemed inevitable. After all, women's lib was not yet even considered, so that means the shepherds were men. Let's face another fact of history. Men tend to be more of a competitive nature. Various forms of golf were played as early as the 14th century. These games were played in Holland, Belgium, France, as well as in Scotland. Thus, the debate of golf's origin is rightly fueled. There is another historical fact that Scottish Baron James VI was the man who delivered the game we know today as golf to the English. For many years, the game was played on severely rugged terrain, where no proper upkeep was required. In most accounts, golf was played with crudely cut holes in the ground where the earth was reasonably flat. It was a group of Edinburgh golfers who first formed an organized club. In 1744, the Honorable Company of Edinburgh Golfers was established. At this time in history, the first 13 laws of golf were drawn up for an annual competition. This first competition consisted of players from any part of Great Britain or Ireland. One of the earliest golf clubs that were formed outside golf's debatable native home of Scotland was the Royal Blackheath Golf Club of England. Blackheath came into existence in 1766, and the Old Manchester Golf Club was founded on the Kersall Moor in 1818. By the late 1800s, the Royal Montreal Club and the Quebec Golf Club were to become the first in North America. It wasn't until 1888 that golf resurfaced in the United States with more fervor than each prior surfacing. Even then, it was a Scotsman, John Reed, who built a 3-hole course in Yonkers, New York. St. Andrew's Club of Yonkers was built in a 30-acre site near the original 3-hole course. From the hesitant and fitful start, golf grew rapidly as the new national pastime in America. Modern for its time, the golf club, Shinnecock Hills, was founded in 1891, and in the 9 years left in that century, more than 1,000 prestigious golf clubs opened in North America. The historical value of golf is as interesting as any part of our heritage. Following the path that golf took to get from a shepherd's field to the amazing golf courses that dot our culture today, it is no wonder golf remains a popular pastime in all parts of the world. A good golf bag is a beautiful thing. Few things are more important to a golfer than a good golf bag. First off, golf bags come in many styles and a wide variety of colors. You can choose a bag for style, features, or pick a color to match your mood. Some have legs that fold out when they are placed on the ground and stand upright so the golfer doesn't have to bend down and pick it up. That's a nice feature in golf bags, especially if the golfer tends to walk the course, as many do. There is plenty of bending to be done when a golfer is trying to remove an obstacle from around his or her ball or to get the ball out of the cup, so any way to avoid bending over is more than appreciated. All golf bags have compartments where the golf clubs are to be placed. Each golfer has his or her own way of doing this and putting clubs where he or she wants them. Some golfers, though, are lazy and just stick their clubs in the compartments, grabbing whichever one they want when a particular club is needed. But some golf bags have tubes to protect the club grips. These are nice to have. With the tubes, a golfer can get his or her clubs out easier. The clubs are never tangled up, and the grips last a lot longer. Another important factor in choosing a golf bag is the number of pockets it has. Frankly, there's no such thing as too many pockets in a golf bag. First, one of the pockets will be used to hold the golf bag's hood. The hood is used to keep the clubs and bag from getting drenched when it rains. Another pocket will be used to keep extra towels. Believe it or not, extra towels are important in the summer to keep the sweat off the brow and out of the eyes, along with keeping the hands relatively dry. Then, there is the pocket used for keeping the extra golf tees and possibly the divot tool. Finally, a pocket is needed for the golf balls themselves, and it doesn't hurt to have a pocket to carry another dozen balls just in case. Some courses are so difficult it's easy to lose a lot of balls during 18 holes of play. This makes having an extra box of balls around a good thing, but there has to be somewhere in the golf bag to keep them, which means another pocket. Imagine trying to play golf without a bag. The golfer would be constantly stooping over and picking up the clubs, tees, balls, towels, and the divot tool. Then he or she would have to walk to the ball, drop all of the clubs and stuff, select a club, hit the ball, and start the process all over again. It would be a major pain in the neck and would make it nearly impossible to finish playing a round of golf. So golf bags are an essential part of the game of golf. Are golf lessons for you? If you've been thinking about taking up golf, or you're a golfer in search of a better game, you may have considered golf lessons. But are golf lessons really beneficial? And how do you find a pro who will offer good advice? There are some who swear that lessons are vital and others who say that practice is the only thing that will improve your golf game. The truth seems to lie somewhere in the middle. But before you drop your coach or sign up for lessons, consider what it is that you hope golf lessons will accomplish. Outlining your goals may help you decide whether you truly need lessons or simply more time on the course. If you play with others who play exceptionally well, you may want to find someone to give you some help with your game. Whether that's a paid coach or merely a friend who plays well is strictly a personal choice. Getting some pointers and tips may be a good way to ensure that you don't totally embarrass yourself in front of other players. If you're serious about the game, you've probably been involved long enough that you don't need advice on whether to get a coach. But if you've only recently discovered the joy of golfing, you may find yourself looking for a way to improve your game. Golf lessons could very well be the answer. Some people say that lessons give them a set time to practice and an opportunity to completely focus on the game. You'll typically be less interrupted than if you were playing on your own, stopping to chat with friends along the way. But others say the simple fact of having someone scrutinizing every move and offering constant advice is more distracting than helpful. Decide whether you're one of those who accept direction and works well in that situation. That's a major clue as to whether golf lessons are a good idea. Remember that a golf coach's job is to teach you to golf correctly. That means there are some habits that he or she will be trying to ingrain and others they'll be trying to break. While golfing correctly is a terrific goal, many golfers have some bad habits that they tout as benefiting their game. Changing your grip, adjusting your stance, or even using different equipment may be among the must-do list from your coach. You may resist those changes. You have two options. You can do your best to follow the instructions, or you can explain that you aren't planning to change that particular habit. If you don't plan to change, you may need to re-examine your decision to take lessons. Without following directions, lessons may become a waste of time and effort on both parts and money on yours. Golf lessons are great for some people. It's a personal decision whether you are one of those who will benefit from a coach, formal or informal. But remember that the most important thing to improve your golf game is simply practice. Are golf shoes really necessary? While some kind of footwear is required on most golf courses, are golf shoes really necessary? This is a question to be answered by each individual golfer, as it is his or her feet we are talking about. Some courses require soft spikes only so the course doesn't get chewed up with the walking around people have to do when playing, especially if the people are walking the entire course. and most clubhouses will only allow soft spikes to be worn inside to protect the carpet. Let us be honest with one another. The vast majority of golf shoes are not attractive footwear, but golf shoes are far from being the ugliest footwear in sports. That honor, dubious though it may be, belongs entirely to bowling shoes. Who in their right mind would want to wear red and green shoes, especially that type of shoes? At least golf shoes are designed in a more practical and somewhat more attractive manner, but are they really needed in order for a person to play golf? No, they are not. The footwear a golfer chooses to wear can be practically anything from moccasins to a good athletic shoe. A golfer's footwork is more important than his or her choice of footwear. But the shoe a golfer wears should be comfortable on his or her feet. There is nothing worse for a golfer than an uncomfortable shoe. If the toes are pinched or the back rides up on the heel, the golfer will be miserable and will not be able to concentrate on playing golf, which is why he or she is on the golf course in the first place. So comfort comes first. After comfort, traction is important. This is because the golfer can't have their feet turning after they've struck the ball. If this happens, the ball will careen wildly, most likely winding up as a major league slice or hook. The ball, though, will not go where the golfer had planned to hit it. Should a golfer choose to forego golf shoes for another type of footwear, he or she should think about the type of shoe he or she wants to wear on the links. They should then examine the tread pattern on the bottom of the shoe. If the bottom of the shoe is slick with no pattern at all, it would be a good idea to leave these shoes behind, as there will be a little, if any, traction, and none at all if the course is wet, either from rain or dew. What is the best type of tread pattern? Again, this will be up to the individual golfer and his or her preferences. For some, the old tire tread pattern, used on the sole of a lot of boots and sandals, works well. This type of shoe sole will provide traction for the golfer. Some may prefer a circular pattern of sole, while others may like something entirely different. The most important thing, though, is for the golfer to be comfortable and confident with the shoes being worn when playing. In fact, the less a golfer thinks about shoes when playing is a good thing. Cleaning your golf clubs. You and your golf clubs have been through a lot together. The four-person benefit scramble, the company tournament, and weekends of enjoyment. They become an integral part of your life, so it makes sense to take good care of them. Golf club maintenance is easy and adds years of life to your set by simply keeping them clean. All you will need is a bucket, some mild dish liquid, not the kind used for automatic dishwashers, an old toothbrush, and some soft towels. It helps to do the cleaning outside so you can rinse them with a water hose, but you may choose to clean them in the bathroom or utility room if the clubs are not too dirty. First, pour a few drops of dish liquid in the bucket. Add warm water and briskly swish your hand back and forth in the bucket to create warm, sudsy water. Don't fill the bucket too full. You want the water to cover the heads of your golf clubs, but not much else. Put your irons into the bucket of warm, sudsy water. Use a cloth to bathe them. It is that simple. Once you have given the clubs a simple washdown, get the toothbrush and scrub the heads to remove dirt from the grooves. Depending on how dirty your clubs are, this might take a little effort and some elbow grease. Once you have washed your golf clubs and cleaned their grooves, you will need to rinse them. A sprayer works great, so if you are outside, simply hose off the soap and dirt with the outdoor water hose. Indoors, use the shower. You can simply run them under a faucet inside, too. No matter how you choose to rinse the clubs, make sure you dry them well. Use another clean cloth and dry the club. Make sure it dries completely to avoid spots and damage. Clean the handles and any woodwork on the golf clubs with a dampened cloth. It is safest not to ever submerge golf club woodwork into water. The water might damage the coloring, protective coat, or the wood itself. While your clubs are out, clean out your bag. A quick wipe down of the bag's interior with a damp cloth is generally all the inside needs. Follow up with a wipe down using a dry cloth. Spot clean the outside of your bag after each golf outing as needed. Once the clubs have been individually washed and dried, return them to the clean bag. If you think this is silly to wash and dry your golf clubs, look around next time you're at the course. Make note of how many other golfers are playing with clean clubs. They take care of them because the clubs are an instrumental tool of the sport, just like cleaning a gun after the hunting season or target practice. When you take good care of your golf clubs after each outing, you'll be ready to hit the greens for your next tee time. Customized and personalized golf. You can have any number of personally detailed golf accessories. Customized golf equipment, accessories, or paraphernalia is a wonderful gift idea for the golfer in your life. It's also a wonderful purchase for your own golf needs. Golf clubs alone have some original accessories that are easily found and made more special with personal touches. The idea of personalizing golf equipment can begin with the gold bag that carries the precious cargo of your clubs. Monogram stitched into the leather or canvas is an unobtrusive way to show ownership and also to personalize. Using monogrammed golf towels or using golf balls with your name on them is a great way to personalize the golf scene without being tacky or presumptuous. And you never know when a large bag of discount personalized golf tees could really come in handy. Golf clubs with the owner's name engraved in them is the beginning of a long list of wonderful personalized and customized golf equipment. Needing golf clubs that vary from the ordinary in height, length, or strength is what customizing is all about. You will discover there is a whole retail world out there that thrives on customization. Golf clubs are indeed just the beginning. Golf apparel is no exception to the personal side of golf. Comfortable and affordable clothes, shoes, hats, and umbrellas are just a few of the enormous choices available for personalized golf. With discount and wholesale golf apparel shops offering every affordable style is made available to the golfing public, there is no reason not to be original in your appearance on the golf course. So many great gift ideas come to mind when you think about customizing and personalizing golf equipment. Head covers can boast the family crest, or they can even be a knitted gift from your teenage daughters for your birthday. Either way, they are equally cherished for their unique sentimental value. Customizing your vacation to include a home rented in advance in Augusta, Georgia, for a personal view of the Masters can be an amazing way to show your loyalty to the sport of golf. Being up close and personal to such an event is something planned well in advance and could be in some cases a once-in-a-lifetime occurrence. Customized and personalized can go hand in hand and need not be so expensive. Creating your own tournament for a good cause is always a fun project for the entire family or helpful organization. Customizing your golf accessories can range from the practical to the outrageous. Installing seat warmers or air conditioners in your golf car might seem a little extravagant to some people. If you are serious about your golf, these accessories and customizations are deemed a necessity. A seat warmer or a range finder may seem trivial in comparison to some extravagant examples. Golf cars that look like the SUVs in your driveway may seem a little excessive. If you have the money to indulge in such luxuries, then so be it. Who said a Rolls-Royce golf car was over the top? Drivers, not just for chauffeuring you around. In golf, the driver is also known as the one wood. Normally, it's the longest club in the bag and has the largest head. This club is used to hit the ball off the tee out of the box, which is where the ball is teed up to start playing a hole. Of course, on a short par 3 hole, the driver would be left in the bag and another club would be selected unless the golfer just had a hankering to fly the green and blow any chance at making a birdie or par. Now, it should be noted that the club known as the driver is not something that can be used to literally drive someone around. If anyone put the club behind the wheel of their car and climbed into the back seat expecting to be chauffeured to a specific destination or just driven around in general, they will have a very, very, very long wait. After all, it is a golf club, not someone who gets paid to drive cars. It does not have arms or legs, nor does it have eyes or ears. You will note that there was no mention of a brain, but that is because there are so many people on the road who also do not appear to have a functioning brain while they are driving. On the other hand, a driver, the golf club, is a great way to get the ball down the links on the golf course. A well-hit ball can travel more than 300 yards. However, this kind of driving power is most often seen on the Professional Golf Association, PGA Tour. The average golfer is doing well to hit the ball 250 to 275 yards off the tee, and these are not drives to be ashamed of. There is no set average distance for holes on the golf course, which makes driving on different courses a major challenge in some cases. Some par 4 holes can be as short as 285 yards, while others can be closer to 500 yards in length. Either way, a well-hit drive is required to do well in the game of golf. The basic idea of driving the golf ball is to keep the ball in the fairway, out of the rough, avoiding sand traps, and most definitely staying away from any water hazards the course may have to offer. This concept, though, is easier said than done. After all, the least little thing can affect the golfer's concentration. This can result in the ball being towed or hit off the front of the driver, or heeled, which is when the ball is hit off the back part of the driver. Those are bad things. Towing a drive will send a ball sharply to the right if the golfer is right-handed, or to the left if the golfer is a southpaw. Consequently, a drive hit off the heel of the club will go left for the right-handed player and right for the lefty. Getting ready to play starts at the driving range. All golf courses, reputable ones anyway, have driving ranges. This has nothing to do with the maneuverability of a golf cart, but the player practicing shots and getting loosened up for a round on the links. The driving range is the best place to practice a new shot or technique that the golfer has heard about, but has not tried as of yet. It is never a good idea for the golfer to attempt a new shot or a new grip on the golf course. This is because a muffed shot, and those are easy to hit, can cause the golfer to lose faith in the stroke, the club, or the grip he or she was using. Therefore, it is always best to work on the shot at the driving range before ever considering trying it on the course. Every golfer has his or her own way of getting ready to play when they go to the driving range. For some, the idea is to take the smaller clubs, such as the pitching wedge, hit a few balls to get loosened up, then hit with the larger and larger clubs, finishing up the workout with the woods. But for others, he or she will start with the larger clubs, getting their stroke down with the driver and woods first, then working their way to the smaller clubs, such as the pitching and sand wedges. For others, though, they will take one particular club to work on. This is normally done when a golfer is having problems hitting this club regularly. By using only one club, the golfer has to focus on what they are doing with it. Are they gripping the club in a comfortable manner that will allow their wrists to be flexible on the follow-through? Or is their stance too closed or too open? This can have an adverse effect on a shot, with a closed stance preventing the golfer from getting the distance he or she thinks he or she should get with this particular club. A stance too wide will affect the golfer's balance and therefore the accuracy of the shot. There are some of the things a golfer will work on at the driving range. But then again, there is always the new tip that is guaranteed to increase both the length of a shot and the accuracy of the shot. And there's also oceanfront property in Oklahoma for those interested in making such a purchase. A lot of these so-called tips are ways for someone else to make money from golfing equipment or videos. Still, there are some tips that are legitimate and will help. Regardless, all tips should be tried out on the driving range before the golfer ever thinks about stepping up to the tee on the first box. Remember, though, the driving range is not for all-terrain vehicles, four-wheel drive pickups, monster trucks, or to see how sharp a golf cart can be turned. A driving range is a place where golfers go to get ready for their game and try new tips. Getting a grip on golf terminology. Regardless of how much you've played golf, you're probably going to hear some new terminology every time you're golfing with a new group or working with a new instructor. The way to save face is simply nod like you know exactly what they're talking about, even when they're touting new words. The smart thing to do is to ask. Even a casual golfer knows words like bogey, slice, and approach. But did you know that ballata is the rubbery substance that covers a golf ball? Here are a few terms that may be less well known to some golfers. A chunk is that boo-boo of hitting the ground behind the ball, way behind the ball. The word came about because the chunk of grass, the divot, that flies up can sometimes travel a longer distance than the ball. When it's done on purpose, as from a sand bunker, the resulting shot is called an explosion. When the ball is really buried in that sand, it's known as a fried egg. A top shot is when you simply hit too high on the ball. One of the most common causes is that you've hit several chunks and you're trying to compensate. When you hit a top shot, the ball will have little or no loft. If you're already in a sand trap, you're likely to stay there for another shot. If there's one directly in front of you, a top shot will probably net you a fried egg. A mulligan is the same as a do-over from your childhood days. This is when you aren't satisfied with your first shot, and you simply pull another ball from your bag and start over. Typically, a mulligan can only happen when you're playing alone or with very forgiving friends, because few golfers are going to let an opponent have a free do-over. Yips is a word used to denote the inability to complete a putt with a slow, steady movement. For various reasons, the golfer instead makes a sudden, jerky swing, usually causing the putt to go wild. The address is commonly known as that moment that the golfer steps up to the ball. What some don't realize is that USGA rules say that the address has occurred once the golfer has rested the club behind the ball. Nassau is a popular way of competing, especially for those who are something less than professional-minded. In this game, golfers have one score for the first 9 holes they play and a separate score for the back 9, as well as an overall score for the entire round. That means that golfers have three scores to compare, upping the odds of winning something. There are other terms that you should know as well. The grain refers to the way the grass angles, similar to the grain of fabric. Loft is the angle of the face of the club. Dormy means that the person with a lower score can't hope for anything more than a tie. Learning the terminology isn't necessary to playing a good game, but it probably is necessary to enjoying playing with friends. Gifts for the female golfer. Ladies' golf is fast becoming the thing women do in their spare time. It is no wonder why it is such a popular sport. Whether you have a lady golfer in your life or you are one, there are many unique and customized lady golfer accessories from which to choose. When it comes to clubs, balls, and tees, the female flair for pretty things is not lost. Flower-shaped golf tees may actually seem a little over the top to some, but others may find that to be just what they had in mind. A feminine grip for golf clubs would in some cases be much smaller than the male's, so this is another area where the lady style would accommodate and flatter the female golfer. Perhaps golf balls that were pink might seem just the thing for a lady golfer. However, using any color or type of golf ball is also an option. Apparel is probably the one place where most women golfers might stand out and not share a commonality with their male counterparts. When looking for a great gift for the lady golfer in your life, look no further than the latest in golf apparel. You will find a number of shades and brand names with loose-fitting comfortable front stretch or front pleated shorts available. There will also be many comfortable blouse styles certain to fit the taste of every lady golfer. Front stretch skorts are also a big hit. And don't forget that cropped pants or a stretched slack in the cooler weather is ideal golf apparel. From thermal outerwear to open and breezy styles, you will find just your style available for every type of weather. Certain name brands are exclusive to the lady golfer and worn proudly. Good solid golf shoes are also vastly important accessories to any golf game. Replacement spikes and spike cleaners are found in any pro shop and for any type of cleat or spike. You may wish to purchase a wrench kit to make spike replacement more simple and fast. And suede shoe bags are a fashion statement, as well as a distinct means of keeping the golf course out of the trunk of your car. Adding the feminine colors is not the only way to make golf accessories for women stand in a unique light. There is also a style unique to the lady golf accessories. Women's golf gloves, hats, and visors are also a great gift idea. Sunglasses that block UV rays and prevent unnecessary glare are a wonderful gift idea. Golf towels and head covers can be personalized in any number of ways. Golf bags and luggage accessories for women can also be personalized. Golf jewelry can be found. Rhinestone letter charms and any number of golf-related charms are always a great gift for the lady golfer. Gift certificates can be purchased in any increment and make excellent gifts for the golfer who has everything. Gifts can be purchased at any number of online or real-time accessory shops in the world. Golf. More than a walk through the pasture. Mark Twain once wrote, "Playing golf was a good way to spoil a walk through the pasture." The inimitable Mr. Twain from this statement could be believed not to be a golfer. After all, there is more to golfing than just walking through a pasture. First and foremost, golf is a way to either work out stress and frustration, or, for many, to even get more stressed out and frustrated. It can be the most infuriating game ever played or invented, or the most fun. And no two trips to the golf course will ever be the same, regardless of how good a player someone is. This is because the weather conditions are never identical, and weather does play a big part in golf. The more intelligent golfers will not go near the course in a thunderstorm, but there are a few brave and foolhardy souls who will brave the elements just to play. The wind also plays a major factor in golf, as the wind will affect the way the ball travels. When hit, golf balls have spin. The spin can be enhanced by the wind, causing the ball to drift away from its intended target. Therefore, the golfer has to take the wind into consideration and plan his or her shot accordingly. Golf is also a good form of exercise for those golfers who walk the course. A good course is about 2 miles around, so playing 18 holes is roughly equivalent to walking 4 miles. Any doctor will tell you that such a walk can only be beneficial to the walker's heart and lungs. Additionally, playing golf is good for getting out of the house and being outdoors. Golfers can enjoy the sun and wind, note the beauty of the nature they're surrounded by, as the majority of courses are well landscaped and quite pleasing to the eye. Golfers can also watch squirrels and rabbits on the course and sometimes take pleasure in the antics of these creatures. This also helps free the golfer from thinking about the mistake he or she made on the last shot or previous hole, calming them down and getting them ready for their next shot. For others, however, playing golf is a great way to beat stress. After all, a golf course is about the only place a person can knock the crap out of something, not only to get in trouble for hitting something, but being praised and rewarded by knocking the crap out of the ball well. How perfect is that? Golf is also a game of honor. Surprised? Don't be. After all, golf is the only game where a person can call a penalty on themselves, and those who play with honor do. Of course, there are the jerks who claim to play golf, but wouldn't think of calling a penalty on anything they've done. Their scores, though, are meaningless, and this kind of behavior will also show up in their day-to-day lives. Golf accessories. What's hot? What's not? As with any sport, golf has diverse and useful personal accessories. Whether you are searching for a gift to give your favorite golfer, or you are in need of an accessory to make your own golfing experience more effective and pleasant, there are many accessories from which to choose. Every price range is available, and millions of products can be found in several diverse venues. Every aspect of the game of golf has its own unique set of accessories from which to choose. Just your golf clubs alone can require various accessories. There are cleaning kits for golf clubs. Golf clubs can be fitted with head covers to protect your investment in quality clubs. Head covers can vary greatly from funny animal shapes to serious covers monogrammed with your family crest. Golf club grips can also be diverse. There are your everyday universal grips, and you can also find some very expensive custom fit grips for any golf clubs. Golf tees and balls are accessories that leave nothing to the imagination. Think again. There are so many choices in tees and balls, it's mind-boggling. There are inexpensive bags of discount generic golf tees available, and you can also find personalized golf tees in every color imaginable. There are rubber tees and brush tees. Brush tees claim to give you increased accuracy and are also touted to last longer than normal wooden ones. Golf balls can be found in various colors and with any number of claims to their accuracy. There will always be times when golf accessories will be chosen strictly because of a personal preference as opposed to what the manufacturer claims it might do. When considering accessories for the golfer in your life or for your own purchase, you can choose from a wide variety of sunglasses, caps, or visors. Depending on where you live or what climate in which you play golf, you may need more than one of these particular accessories. Wrap-around sunglasses as well as the UV protectant lenses can cut glare in many cases up to 100%. With a clear view, your golfing accuracy will be much improved. Umbrellas will also come in handy in sunshine or in rain. What would any golfer do without his favorite and sometimes lucky golf towel hanging on his bag? There are any number of logos and brand name golf towels sold. Golf towels serve not only a utilitarian purpose, but they are also a way to personalize your game. Ball cleaners can be found in any accessory shops, along with a wide variety of maintenance products for every level of golfer out there. Ball retrievers are yet another accessory that proves to remain a useful accessory for any golfer. Here again, you will find generic ball retrievers that work efficiently and are affordable, or you can give a personalized ball retriever in any style to the golfer on your holiday gift list. Golf balls, the first piece of basic equipment. No matter how good a golfer may be, he or she will not be any good at all without golf balls. Granted, it is a no-brainer that golfers need to have golf balls in order to play. But the question is, which golf balls are the best? This is a sticky situation and depends almost entirely on the individual golfer and his or her taste, what he or she expects out of the ball, and quite frankly, how much money he or she wants to spend. There are golfers out there who will play with nothing but one brand of ball. No matter what else happens, they will only and always use this particular brand. What these balls cost is irrelevant to them. It is this ball or no golf. Yes, this is going to extremes, but let's face it, there are people in this world who prefer living life at the extreme edge of sanity. Now, let's get down to some common sense when it comes to the golf ball. We shall start with the beginning golfer. The beginner needs to forget what he or she may have heard about any brand or type of golf ball, what it does and how far it goes. Beginning golfers are going to lose a lot of golf balls. They need to think more about price than quality. The beginner golfer needs to purchase bin-around balls, which are balls sold in bulk, around 50 to a bag, that have been found on golf courses and recycled, for lack of a better word. Okay, these used golf balls are more often than not name-brand balls, but this does not matter. The beginning golfer in learning how to hit the ball straight, keep it in the fairway, out of the woods and water, will go through dozens, if not hundreds, of golf balls. Therefore, the logical thing for the beginning golfer to do is buy in bulk. As the golfer gets better, the best idea would be to move up to a better grade of ball. This, though, does not mean to rush out to the nearest golfing supply house and buy the most expensive ball on the shelves. Again, think about the price of the ball and the level of your skill. If a player has a tendency to slice the ball or tends to top the ball, this is where the club head hits the top of the ball. While it gives the ball a lot of topspin, the ball does not travel far and tends to be gashed by the club. Stick with cheap balls. This does not mean stay with the bulk recycled balls, but inexpensive new ones. In theory, players get better the more they play. As the skill level increases, the golfer can experiment with different brands of golf balls, checking to see which ones he or she may like the best. And a lot of thought should be given to the type of course the golfer will be using these balls on. Golf clubs, the perfect fit. If you think any old golf clubs will do, you haven't been on the course trying to compensate for a club that's simply too long or too short. Besides making a shambles of your golf game, ill-fitting clubs can leave your body aching after the game. If you're spending all your time compensating, you probably aren't shooting your best or even enjoying the time on the course. So does that mean you're going to spend hundreds of extra dollars on a set of clubs with a custom fit? While custom clubs are one answer, most people can find what they need from a well-stocked golf store. But there are some things to keep in mind. Length of the club is important, but it's not everything. The pros say that the size of your golf club's grip should be comfortable for your hands. That's why clubs for younger players and women often have a smaller grip. If you should decide to go for a set of custom clubs, what is the process? It's nothing like being measured for a suit. The point is not only to make the club reach from the point of your outstretched hand to the ground, but also to make the most of your body, your strengths, and your weaknesses. So don't go for your custom golf club fitting session expecting to spread your arms and stand still while someone uses a tape measure. A good custom fit will probably take place both inside and outside. The best custom fit clubs will be tailored so that your swing is taken into account. Sound expensive? Possibly. While some major golf club manufacturers will charge dearly for the actual fitting, many offer up this service for free, with your commitment to buy clubs from that company. While custom clubs are more expensive than clubs purchased off the shelf from your local golf supplier or even an outlet store or individual, the results will probably show themselves right away on the golf course. Consider the shots that you may have been compensating for all your years of playing golf. If you're taller or shorter than the typical golfer, or even if you have some muscle strengths or weaknesses that make your game a bit more of a challenge, custom clubs can help you compensate. But what if you want the clubs immediately? Do you have to go with off-the-shelf clubs? Actually, many manufacturers who provide custom golf clubs promise delivery within just a few days, a week or two at most. Among the few negatives of custom golf clubs is the potential for offering them up as a surprise gift and the potential for resale. But at the same time, the golfer who is going to receive the custom clubs will likely gladly give up the surprise, and most who go to this expense and trouble aren't going to offer the clubs for sale. Only you can decide whether custom golf clubs are a good investment for you. If you're going to spend a bundle of money for an awesome set of clubs, you may very well take the extra step to get custom clubs. Golf courses. Same course, new game every time. One thing every golfer will agree on is no golf course is ever the same. While playing different courses is fun and challenging, playing one's home course, no matter how many times it is done, is always going to be different. Yes, it is the same course. Nothing has been changed except for the position of the cup on the green, but no golf course is ever exactly the same 2 days in a row, or for that matter, the same day. Will Smith in the movie The Legend of Bagger Vance told his protege how the grass follows the sun, which means a putt that broke one way in the morning will break in the opposite direction in the afternoon. Another thing that makes the same course different every day is the weather conditions. Weather plays a big factor in golf and how a course plays. A wet course will play slower, and the ball will not travel as far after hitting the ground. On a dry course, the ball will roll farther after hitting the turf. A course will also play differently in hot or cold weather. Colder weather keeps the ball from traveling as far, while a well-hit ball will go further on a warm or hot day. Additionally, if an area has been dry for any length of time, the fairways, unless they are watered heavily every day, will become as hard as concrete and provide extra distance once the ball hits the ground. Then comes the golfer's attitude. Yes, the frame of mind a golfer is in will have a direct effect on how well he or she plays and reacts to the course. Golf is a game requiring a calm, focused mind, so the player can concentrate on what he or she is trying to do on any particular shot. One other thing that will make the same course play differently is how the grounds are kept. If the fairway is allowed to grow a little long, balls will not be able to roll as far, whereas if they are kept trimmed close to the ground, the ball will roll farther. The rough is a whole other problem, as are other obstacles on the course such as sprinkler heads. The rough is always going to be thick and hard to play out of, but a heavy, wet rough makes it almost impossible for a golfer to do much more than simply attempt to chip back onto the fairway. Sprinkler heads, which are positioned all over the course, will have an adverse effect on a ball that happens to hit them. Believe it or not, who a person is playing with, or if he or she is playing alone when he or she normally plays with someone else, will affect the way a course is played. So this only goes to show how the same course, no matter how many times a person plays it, is never the same course twice. Golf gadgets, from the great to the ridiculous. There are tons of golf gadgets out there, mainly because of the incredible increase in the popularity of the sport. The more people who are ready to play the game, the more they're all looking for ways to improve their game. The result is that an industry that was doing fairly well before has boomed. There are entire companies built around a single golf gadget, and the results range from incredible golf aids to the ridiculous contraptions. Take a look at some of your options. If you are having trouble finding time to hit the driving range, and your backyard is too limited for driving practice, you have some options. You can play virtual golf, but this lacks the satisfying feel of the club striking the ball. You might find that a limited flight ball is the answer you've been looking for. These are just what the name implies. You have a ball that you place on the tee, then hit it just like any other ball, but the ball won't travel outside a particular area. Or you can work with a regular ball and a net. The catch here is that you have to hit the net every time. Of course, putting pads and practice aids for your putting game have been around for ages. Give yourself the advantage of practice time in your office or living room. Choose from kits that are as simple as a pad with a cup or those that offer features such as ball return. If you're into technology, you might find good use for a digital scorekeeper. Not only do you have an immediate way of tracking your score on the course, you have a digital record that you can save. Instantly recall scores from past games to help improve your current game. Every dedicated golfer has probably been at the receiving end of some silly golf gifts. Think covers for your golf clubs. From handmade crochet covers to cutesy cartoon characters and everything in between. There are probably few ideas for golf club covers that haven't been tried on the market, and these seem to be universal golf gifts. Covers do serve a purpose, and many golfers are even secure enough to walk the course with tigers and mouse heads proudly protruding from the golf bag. Are you having trouble lining up the exact spot you should be aiming for on the golf ball? You can find a stencil to help. Simply use the stencil to mark the ball, place it on the tee as directed, and you've got a clear target. How about a metronome? No, you're not going to be taking your guitar onto the golf course, but a golf metronome can help you work on the rhythm of your swing. There's no doubt that the golfers have tons of gadgets to choose from. Many offer real help to the golfer, while others are simply ways to collect money for a useless product. Some of these gadgets and gizmos will be completely wasted on one golfer, but will be just what another needs to improve their golf game. Golf movies. What will they think of next? There are several movies set around golf in some form, and golfers may be tempted to critique the players and the golf games played in those movies. If you're a die-hard golfer and always anxious to watch the next golf movie, be aware of your motives. If you're looking for instruction, you'll probably be disappointed. The golfers of movies never make a bad swing unless they were supposed to. It's the magic of Hollywood. But golf movies do have the ability to motivate us as golfers, or even as would-be golfers. Hollywood will make a movie about anything, literally, and the sport of golf is no exception. And with Hollywood making golf movies comes the fact that some of them are good, while others are not worth watching. This, though, will be up to the individual who makes the choice of which movie to see. We will start with a golf movie starring Kevin Costner and examine it, following it with Matt Damon, Will Smith's entry, and end up with Adam Sandler. Know this, while these are three golf movies, they are not the only ones out there or available. Beginning with Tin Cup, we find a golfing legend, but are never really told how Roy McIlvoy achieved legendary status. We are informed he is a world-class ball striker who has a knack for never finishing anything. The fun begins when he meets Rene Russo, a local psychologist. Through a series of trial and error, Cup, as the character is most often called, finds himself qualified for the U.S. Open. Theoretically, this is possible, but highly unlikely, as making the cut for the Open is extremely difficult for tour players, much less driving range pros. Overall, it's not a bad movie. It's nearly impossible to foresee the fiasco Costner will face once he is at the Open, or even the encouragement he gets from Russo. Next comes The Legend of Bagger Vance, where Will Smith helps Matt Damon find himself and what is important to him through golf. The movie begins with the father of Charlize Theron killing himself after building the course, only to have the depression hit. Theron extorts Bobby Jones and Walter Hagen to play in a match tourney. The town leaders insist on a local golfer playing as well, with Damon's character getting rooked into it. There are no losers in the movie, as all three tie at the end of play. However, Damon and Theron, who were married before he went to World War II, get back together. It is presumed they remarry and live happily ever after. Throughout the movie, though, Smith, Bagger Vance, provides spiritual guidance for Damon, and the narrator, Hardy Greaves. Next up is Sandler's Happy Gilmore, a most improbable golf movie as Sandler, a failed hockey player, takes up golf on a lark and finds he's a natural. However, any golfer attempting to make the shots Gilmore makes will not only look ridiculous, but could injure himself in the process. Gilmore's driving style, hopping toward the ball, simply will not work on the golf course, as the slightest misstep will see the ball careen who knows where, if the player connects with the ball at all. Of course, Happy Gilmore is not supposed to be a serious golf movie. Sandler is a comedian, and the movie shows this quite well. But for a more serious golf movie, there is a recent one about Bobby Jones and what he went through. Golf Swing Analysis Software for Perfecting Your Game. When it comes to perfecting your golf game, the style and technique of your swing may be the single most important aspect on which to focus. There are many instructional videos and software available to the general public that aid in perfecting a golf swing. When you're an amateur or a professional, you can benefit from having your golf swing technique and style analyzed. After all, one main key to a successful golf game is your swing. The key to perfecting your swing is by analyzing your technique and style. Golf swing analysis can be achieved with the newest software available, or with software that has been around and been proven time and again to create a better swing in all shapes and sizes of golfers. Whether you are a serious die-hard golfer or a recreational weekend warrior type golfer, there is a golf swing analysis software that will help you discover where your swing might be going wrong. More importantly, you will learn how to improve your swing so that your fullest potential will be met on the golf course. With the newest technology available to you in software format, there is no reason that you should not be playing golf like the professionals. With a little patience and some hard work, you will cause envy in your golf buddies with amazing stroke power and gentle control where needed. Easing your way from one hole to the next with grace and dignity that only comes from a solid golf swing. Some software available will have instructions from your favorite golf professionals. Other software will use everyday golfers who are as eager as you to perfect their golf swing, creating a notable difference in anyone's golf game in a matter of weeks. No matter which golf swing analysis software you choose, to learn from the results will amaze even the most critical golf mate. If you're looking for proven ways to improve your golf swing, then look no further. Golf swing analysis software has brought golf lessons to your personal computer screen. With the help of your camcorder, you will have an expert analysis of the critical points that are involved in a single swing. Software that improves golf swings with analysis information is user-friendly in most cases and can even be found available as downloads. Free trials are frequently advertised, making the search for the perfect swing improvement tools easier to find. Some of the incredible tools for imaging swings and readying those images for analysis are slow motion cameras and virtual comparison software. Seemingly endless technology-based analysis techniques are available to the general public. There is golf swing help for any caliber of golf participant, and there is also software available for any budget. Golf has gained in popularity in the last decade. This interest has grown due to the phenomenal participants in the public eye. Whether you have recently become a true fan of the sport or have always been a die-hard golf fanatic, if you're ready to improve your golf swing, the latest technology software is the way to go. Golf, a Zen experience? Good golfers center themselves before each and every shot. While it may look effortless, there is a great deal going on. Remember the scene in The Legend of Bagger Vance where Bobby Jones steps up to the ball preparing to tee off? Will Smith tells Matt Damon to watch Jones's eyes and how he sees the field. The eyes go soft as Jones takes his practice swings, getting his mind and body in tune with one another. His drive is as nearly perfect as a drive can be. It may seem a bit far-fetched, and some will object to the statement, for many will recognize the truth of this statement. Golf is a Zen experience. This is especially for the better golfers, no matter how they may joke around and seem to be goofing off. This is what Zen is, being completely and totally in each and every moment at all times. Some people call it living life to its fullest, but that is something entirely different. Zen is more like experiencing every moment of life to its fullest and appreciating the moments for what they are. Golf and Zen coincide on all aspects of the game. By being in the moment, a golfer takes notice of everything around himself or herself. He or she notes the feel of the breeze as it is blowing across the course, recognizing its force and direction, but not actively thinking about it. He or she also notices the feel of the grass as they walk down the fairway, but he or she is not thinking about the next shot. Not yet. Thinking about the shot will occur when the player gets to the ball. At this time, the player will note the distance from where he or she is to the green, the weather conditions, and select a club. Avoiding distractions, the player will focus on how to make the next shot, again though, without really thinking about it. Too much thought fouls up the mental processes, causing the player to get tense and screw up the shot. Instead, the Zen golfer will trust his or her body, knowing the body and mind are in tune with one another, and make the shot. For the record, not every shot will be perfect going exactly where and how the golfer intended, but the major difference is the golfer familiar with and practicing Zen will not be adversely affected by a missed hit shot, whereas a golfer who stresses over every shot will. The non-Zen golfer will get down on himself or herself, thinking how he or she is a lousy golfer and shouldn't be on the course at all. The negative thoughts will be invasive throughout this player's entire body, as the body and mind are at odds with one another instead of being in a state of harmony. So the end result is one bad shot is followed by another, and a good shot is looked upon as an accident, luck, or a fluke. Golf cart repairs and accessories. Expert in-house golf car repairs can be found in only a few minutes with online directories. Any make or model of golf cars will have accessories and repair facilities available. Whether your golf car runs on electricity or with gasoline, you will be able to easily gather information on how to repair it or where to have it repaired through online venues. If shopping or searching online is not how you like to begin, local libraries and telephone directories or simply word of mouth are wonderful alternatives where results will be solid and sound. Reputable retail and repair facilities are more common than fly-by-night facilities. Online shopping provides secure means of purchasing items with credit cards. There are also ways in which online bank transfers are easily handled in a secure atmosphere. Obviously, the means in which you shop is a personal preference. If the large motorized golf cars are not your bag, there are manual golf push carts and pull carts that ease the labor of moving your golf clubs both to and from the course and from one hole to the next. With prices ranging from $60 to $1,000, there are variations on the manual golf carts that are certain to meet the need of any golfer interested in this form of golf club transportation. Golf cars come in every shape and style. There are name brands that are well known and some that are obscure, but each one is backed with guarantees and warranties. There are even Rolls-Royce and Jeep golf cars available to the golfer who apparently has everything. More than a utilitarian purpose, golf cars such as these are used on estates for fast travel from the main house to destinations that are more comfortably achieved in the comfort of a custom golf car. Necessities and accessories for your golf cars can be found in various places. There are repair facilities that offer in-store viewing of many items. There are also websites available with detailed information. Discount part stores are not uncommon, and the user-friendly formatting within most websites leave nothing to the imagination. Deluxe golf car covers, seat warmers, canopies, and air conditioners are among the few of the items found. You can decide if these items fall into the category of necessity or accessory. From cooler bags to batteries and beyond, all your accessory needs will be met efficiently and effectively by established, reputable golf car and golf cart stores. With many websites offering searches by serial numbers, it makes your search for that one specific hubcap or fuse even simpler than it ever was before. There are websites that offer searches by state and then is narrowed down further to cities. Each city then has listing information about each place of business that deals with the sale and repair of golf cars. Knowing what a golf car shop offers as far as repairs, years in business, and charges in advance is always an intelligent way to shop. Golfing always beats working. No matter how well or poorly a golfer plays, one thing each and everyone will agree on is this: a bad day on the golf course is better than the best day at work. Let us take a look at this attitude. We shall start with golf being something that is fun to do, no matter how frustrating the game may become at times. All golfers know, while every shot may not be a thing of beauty, they are in a pristine setting and are not being bothered. Besides, they all know the next shot will look exactly like the ones the professional golfers make on television. Then there is work. Work is what all of us have to do to survive. We get up in the morning, many of us dreading what the day holds, get ready and head to our place of business, whether it is a factory or an office, regardless if the job is blue-collar or white-collar. Work is an ugly four-letter word. Work is where problems are. The employees are expected to help solve these problems, or they will be out of a job. While unemployment would give a person more time to play golf, it would not give them a way to pay their bills, and let's face it, we all like to eat. Work is also where the boss is, and a lot of people have, for lack of a better way to put it, lousy bosses. There are those bosses who are pleasant to work for, who help the employee and understand the needs of those who work for them. Some bosses even set up golf tournaments for their employees, but there are the other kind. Those bosses seldom have anything good to say to any of their employees, are always complaining that the company is not making enough money, no matter what the profit and loss sheet says, and make going to work a miserable experience for everyone around them. This is where golf is much better than work. There are no bosses on the golf course. A person's social or employment ranking means nothing on a golf course. The only thing anyone cares about is how well he or she plays, and whether he or she has a good time while playing. And what is not fun about playing golf? First, it's a great way to get outside and get some exercise, especially if the golfer walks the course. Next, golfing is a good way to socialize with others and meet new people. Golf is also a good way for a person to work out his or her frustrations. Whacking a golf ball not only feels good, but the better the ball is hit, the more praise the golfer gets, even if he or she is playing alone. After all, who hasn't hit a ball well, stopped, watched it in flight, and thought, "Man, that was a great shot"? Therefore, ladies and gentlemen, a bad day on the golf course beats the best day a person can have at work. Golfing in the wind. Weather conditions play an important part in golf, and none more so than wind. While a wet golf course will prevent the ball from rolling as far after being hit and can make it tough to get the ball in the air to begin with, the wind will have more bearing on the outcome of a round of golf than anything. Why is this? Well, first, the wind will affect the trajectory of the ball, taking it out of its intended course of flight and dropping it somewhere the golfer did not intend for it to go. Now, let us remember the majority of golfers, both men and women, are right-handed or play right-handed. The wind will be discussed from the right-handed person's perspective. But first, the golfer must be aware of which way the wind is blowing, even if he or she has no idea of how strong it is blowing. Of course, if a gale-force wind is blowing on the golf course, it will really not matter much how a golfer tries to hit the ball, unless the wind is behind his or her back. In such an event, the golfer would want to get the ball higher and let the wind do most of the work, especially on a drive. Okay, so the golfer is in the tee box, the wind is brisk, blowing from right to left. He or she is looking at a par 3 hole about 150 yards from the tee box to the hole. A golf outsider watches the game. How hard can it be to hit a stationary ball? After all, Major League Baseball players hit balls traveling at speeds all the time. With that in mind, the outsider decides to take up the game of golf with the notion that the game is so relaxing because it requires little effort. Think again. Most of those people give up on the game before they really understand the dynamics of hitting that little ball. It makes sense that an iron club could pelt a little ball hundreds of yards, yet when the new golfer takes his first swing, there is often little movement at all, sometimes no movement, or worse, backward movement. There is a lot more to hitting that little ball than meets the eye. Human nature is to use the iron to cup it under the ball to hit the ball up into the air. But look at the club. It's angled back, not at all designed to cup beneath the ball. So when a golfer tries to scoop up the ball, he or she is really trapping it behind the angled face of the club and the ground. That's why oftentimes the ball doesn't move, or worse, moves backwards just a little bit. Instead of striving to hit up, it's best to learn to hit downward. By hitting down, the angled club will do the work for you, not the upswing of your club. When you hit down, the angle will bump your golf ball forward. It's that simple. But putting power behind that little punt takes some practice. You'll be tempted to swing big and hard. It takes as much practice to resist that temptation as it does to learn to hit the ball. Once you have trained yourself against swinging upward, you will see your hitting start to improve. Now you will begin to understand why there are various golf club options and choices you have to make when making a shot. You'll need to pick your club based on the angle of the club face once you determine how far you want the ball to go and how you need it to perform. If you've been practicing but still don't feel like you've got the hang of it, ask for help. Your golf course should have an attendant on hand who could give you some pointers. Maybe you could take some private lessons. The course pro shop should have suggestions for area teachers, or try the good old buddy method. Ask another golfer you've seen play how he or she does it and if they have any tips for hitting the ball. You may think you sound silly, but when other golfers start to regale you with their tales of learning to hit the ball, almost everyone has had to address that challenge up front. With those tips in mind and maybe even a few lessons behind you, go back to practicing. Just as it takes a while to train your mind to think about hitting downward instead of upward, it takes a while to train your body to actually do it the way you have in mind. Don't give up, and remember, the game is all about relaxing, so don't stress too much over hitting the ball. Instructional golf videos. Where to get them, and what to look for. Instructional golf videos provide illustrated golf lessons and techniques that will improve your game. These lessons are shown in real time, slow motion, and repeated as needed to ensure the viewer is learning. Instructional golf videos can be purchased several different ways. The valuable lessons are diverse and functional, and you will see your overall golf game improve considerably. Given time, anyone can improve skills at any sport. No matter if you play golf on a regular basis or just a novice, there comes a time when what you know limits the outcome of your game. Instructional golf videos will enhance your skills both mentally and physically by providing up-to-date information on technique. Whether it is your swing that needs improving or if the stamina of your game is lacking, there will be helpful advice and instruction available to you. With every aspect of golf laid out in these instructional videos to be scrutinized, you will certainly find the one aspect that needs improvement in your game. Golf is not only a sport whereby you are challenged by other participants, the course also challenges you, and the most challenge comes from within. Improving your game each time you play can only make the experience of golf more pleasant, less frustrating, and always challenging. Golf is a game of high expectation and regards both external and internal elements as key components to the magic of each game. Instructional golf videos are found to fit any budget and also to accommodate any degree of effective golf player. So whether you are into golf for the periodic relaxing game, or if you wish to someday become professional, there is no reason you cannot learn from instructional videos. With new technology and enhanced imaging available, you will be able to watch golf swings as they are being analyzed. Within this in-depth view of an ordinary golf swing, you will be shown the do's and don'ts for a perfectly executed golf swing. Learning a solid stance that will create and channel more power to the golf ball is another part of the instructions. Lastly, but certainly not least, instruction helps you by realizing there are many elements that make variations impossible to avoid. There are key reasons to believe you have something to learn from instructional golf videos. You can find affordable, high-quality instructional golf videos online and in stores. Some of your favorite golf websites will also have free trials available so that you can make a better decision on which video will work for you. These are some of the obvious places you will be able to buy instructional golf videos. If you were to think out of the box, you would also find the library has media available for you to borrow. Don't delay your search for enlightenment. Begin your optimal relaxing time of golf and challenge that which becomes the fun of golf. With instructional videos, you learn more about the game than you ever dreamed imaginable. Learn to putt. Many golfers spend an extraordinary amount of time learning to make an awesome drive. In truth, there's nothing prettier than the golf ball flying through the air and bouncing neatly onto the green, except the ball dropping neatly into the cup. While working on those longer shots is important, poor putting skill can literally lose the game. Learning to putt accurately every time can be a great expenditure of your time. Consistently getting to the green isn't going to do you a lot of good unless you're able to drop the ball once you're there. Take a few tips from the pros regarding the successful putt. The yips are the bane of many golfers on the putt. This is simply a hesitation, rather like a hiccup, that causes you to get a less than smooth putt. A smooth stroke will always lend you better control over the ball. When you're practicing your putt, pay attention to that accuracy. If you're having trouble controlling the line of travel, give yourself some help until you get a better feel for the game. You might find it helpful to make a mark on your club to clearly indicate the center of the putter. Marking the ball may also help you to make a very solid swing. Chalk is a good way to make these marks, because it will easily wipe off after your practice session. Try making yourself a mental picture of the pathway the ball should travel. If that mental picture doesn't help, try laying a piece of string along the ground between your ball and the cup. It may seem like a very simple thing, but watching the point that your ball veers can help you figure out what to do to correct the problem. Too much spin on the putt can create some problems as well. Spin is one of the most difficult things to control, and the short distance at the putt is all about control. If it's a long putt, resist the urge to put too much muscle into the swing. Avoid unnecessary loft. The higher your ball travels, the less control you have over it. You also have to resist the urge to overshoot your target. Overshooting is a problem in many sports, not just golf. Imagine the number of times you've seen someone take a shot at a pool table only to have the ball ricochet off the back of the pocket and bounce back out. The same sometimes happens with baseball, football, and basketball when the person throwing oversteps the amount of power needed to make a successful play. It's human nature to overthrow. Guard against that at the putt. There's little more frustrating than to walk past the cup to a new putting position which is even farther from the cup than the last. All because your swing was simply too powerful and the ball passed over the top of the cup. When you're ready to putt, take a moment and take control before you take the swing. Remember that the control is every bit as important as your aim. Lefty golfers arise. Let's face it, the majority of the world is designed for right-handed people, with the lefties or southpaws virtually ignored. If a right-handed person wants to take up the game of golf, getting equipment is no problem. They can go virtually anywhere to find clubs. The same can't be said for the left-handed person who wants to play from his or her natural side. Of course, there are those lefties who can and do play from the right side. This is fine for those people who can accomplish this feat, but for the majority of southpaws, the only real option is to play from the left side. Actually, this is a misnomer, as the lefty will be playing on the right side of the ball, while the right-handers are on the left side. Left and right in this instance is being used in terms of a person's dominant side. Buying golf clubs for those who play left-handed can be a challenge. Unless he or she lives in a reasonably large city with a good, hopefully national golf supply store, he or she will most likely wind up having to order his or her clubs, whereas the right-handed person can walk in off the streets, make his or her selection, and leave. Most golf stores, though, carry a selection of left-handed sets of clubs with some left-handed putters. This is important as well because it is as difficult to putt from the subordinate side as it is to hit from there. Basically, it does not feel natural to the player, and this will result in poor putting. However, should the southpaw want to upgrade individual clubs, say, go from a metal shaft to a graphite shaft, he or she will most likely have to order the club. The right-hander, though, will simply be able to walk in, select the club he or she wants, and leave, unless he or she is looking for custom clubs and has to get measured, in which case the club will have to be ordered. Because the majority of people in the world, 90% at last count, are right-handed, it only makes sense that golfing equipment would be designed for them. After all, this is where the money is, and golf is an industry as well as a game. But there are companies who realize the lefties of the world want and deserve quality equipment, and quality golf equipment for the left-handed player is available. When on the golf course, the lefty can expect to be razzed by his or her right-handed counterparts and told he or she is playing on the wrong side of the ball. There will likely be other jokes made about the person's left-handedness as well. But golf is a game that makes no exceptions as to a person's dominant side. Courses are designed to be challenging, and challenging they are to both right-handers and left-handers. Some would argue right-handed golfers are better players, but this has no bearing in fact. A good golfer is a good golfer regardless of whether he or she plays from the right or left side. Statistics, however, will show right-handers to be better simply because there are more of them and that the statistics are weighed accordingly. Online golf lessons. There are many ways to achieve golf lessons and many ways to effectively acquire valuable lessons out there. Among the many ways to learn lessons of golf, online golf lessons are one of the fast, effective ways to gain knowledge of strategies and techniques. Improving your golf game while realizing your best potential is one great reason to utilize online golf lessons. Finding the best website for online golf lessons is relatively simple. Perhaps you have already established a comfortable, user-friendly golf website, and that site lends you access to online golf lessons. If not, there are many reputable websites from which to choose. Also, there are varied means in which to utilize the lessons offered. Online golf lessons can include tips on how to improve specific aspects of your golf game. Normally, on most websites, an overall generalization is provided so that you can see the broad scope of golf. This occurs at first, and as you gain more direct knowledge towards where your particular golf game suffers, you can find information that will seem personalized. There will also be valuable information about stance, follow-through of an effective swing, and the finer points of swing analysis. Online golf lessons can even include time and effort geared toward the mental aspect of the game. As we know, golf is a competitive sport in which you are competing against other golfers, the course, and most importantly, yourself. In most cases, online golf lessons are offered on a non-paying basis and are simply included in your favorite golf website. In some cases, you may find golf lessons that are presented in Acrobat Reader formatting and are downloaded into your personal computer at a minimal cost to you. Payment is made in a secure fashion with a credit card. Shopping around to search for the most effective lessons for your level of interest in the sport of golf is of utmost importance. Searching for the perfect lessons for you will serve to keep costs down and also to provide optimal help in areas where you need it most. Most scenarios where golf lessons are available for free or for a cost in a downloadable format, you will be given ample information. This information will be provided to determine if your personal computer has the capacity to download these various programs, and to assure you that your computer also possesses the capabilities to present the lessons in the way they are meant to be viewed. One benefit from utilizing online golf lessons to improve your golf skills is that you can experience the lessons at your leisure. You can study and practice at your leisure, and then, too, have the lessons handy for reviewing when you forget exactly what was being taught. Once you have improved your golf game and see the results you were hoping to see, it is possible you will search for a more specific online lesson for your needs. Knowing where to look and what to expect with effective results can make that search much more pleasant. Pre-owned golf equipment, a real option. If you are on a budget but golf is your sport of choice, then you have many options to purchase pre-owned golf equipment. From gently worn items to golf cars that no longer suit the needs of fellow golfers, there are countless ways to own high-quality, low-priced golf items. And even if you're not on a set income, there are many opportunities to find quality golfing items that are in great condition. Golf clubs are a very intimate part of every golf game. Purchasing used golf clubs can be tricky, but not impossible. If you are patient and have an idea of what type of golf clubs suit you best, resale shops are a penny-wise approach to acquiring high-quality, low-cost golf clubs. In looking for left-handed clubs or other unique features, you might be surprised how easily your search for used clubs will succeed in sound results. Whether you are on a budget or just like to spend your money in a wise manner, used golf clubs are the ticket. Gently worn golf shoes are not an uncommon purchase. Whether found at a yard sale, thrift store, or a pre-owned golf accessory store, name brand and low-cost shoes are an easy find. Here again, patience will be a helpful tool in your search. There is a saying among resale shop patrons, if you're looking for something specific, odds are you won't find it until you have bought it new. An open mind is also a very wonderful thing when shopping resale venues. Used golf balls can be found by the bag at yard sales or thrift stores. These balls are a smart purchase and serve a great need by allowing the golfer a way to practice his or her golf swing without concern to the loss. Bags of tees can be found for minimal cost also. Ball washers, golf towels, and cleat wrench kits are all likely finds in the resale atmosphere. Head covers and other accessories are common among yard sales and in resale shops. Golf cars and carts can be purchased used. Manual push or pull carts can easily be a high-cost item. Purchasing gently used golf carts is another way to stay geared up with quality equipment while money remains in your pocket. There are websites available that make finding replacement parts for motorized golf cars a breeze. Even purchasing a golf car that needs a small amount of maintenance or possibly a new mechanical part or accessory is not an unusually bad decision. Purchasing pre-owned articles is a great way to save money, and most times you will find decent, well-taken-care-of products. In some cases, there are safeguards to take into account so that you are not spending hard-earned money on an item that will only cause you grief, give you a headache, and cost you more money in the long run. More than likely, your pre-owned, resold, or gently used equipment, accessories, and personal golfing items will bring you years of happy use. 7 Iron, the perfect club. Anyone who has seen the movie Tin Cup starring Kevin Costner will understand the importance of the 7-iron, the perfect golf club. A golfer can literally shoot par on just about any course using nothing more than a 7-iron and a putter. Granted, driving with a 7-iron will not get the golfer drives of 300 yards, but then again, this club was not designed to hit the ball that far. But depending on how strong the golfer is, a good shot with a 7-iron can be anywhere from 175 yards to 275 yards, and those are not distances to sneeze at. Following the drive with the 7-iron, the golfer would then make his or her approach shot. Depending on the length of the hole, the golfer will either want a full swing or to cut their swing, thereby adjusting the distance the ball will travel. And again, depending on the distance and weather conditions, the golfer may want to put the ball either in the front or back of their stance. This will give the ball more loft or keep it low, depending on which stance is taken. As the golfer approaches the green, the 7-iron can be used as a wedge to chip the ball onto the green. By closing the stance and hitting the ball in back of the stance, the golfer can flip the ball onto the green. Of course, the golfer will want to cut his or her swing, or they will fly the green, which will result in a lost stroke, possibly a lost ball, and almost definitely them losing their temper. Once the ball has been chipped onto the green, the 7-iron's usefulness is pretty much over, unless the golfer has incredible courage and wants to use the 7-iron as a putter. This, too, was done in Tin Cup, but isn't advisable for the average golfer. On short par 3 holes, the 7-iron is again the perfect club to use. Once again, the golfer can tee the ball up and hit out of the back or front of his or her stance. Depending on the length of the hole, the ball could be teed higher for more loft and less distance. Granted, it does feel awkward to have both feet in front of the golf ball, but it also prevents the golfer from getting too much of a swing and flying the green. It will, however, allow the ball to be hit higher and with more control, and a well-hit 7-iron is a thing of beauty to watch. The ball takes off in a majestic arc, following a predetermined flight plan, if properly struck, flies beautifully through the air, and lands gently on the turf, bringing the golfer one step closer to his or her goal, the cup. A 7-iron is also handy to have around the house, as it is long enough to allow a person to reach behind a couch from one end or the other and drag something out that is in the middle. Some warm-up tips. When it's time to warm